So we have missal stands, but for about several hundred years, and never in the history of the English-speaking church, have we had a missal to put on our missal stand. So the relic of the name remains, but not the book. This is an example of the type of book that ought to be on our missal stands. And so I'm part of a project which is endeavoring to create the first Lutheran missal for our church and to make it available to our pastors to have on our altars. Somebody asked me, what's the difference between an altar book, which you probably have on your missal stand, and a missal itself? And I replied, can you conduct the divine service from that book and only that book for every day of the year? And the answer was, no, of course we can't. Even on Sundays, you can't conduct the service from whatever we have now, because it might tell you the readings, but it's not going to give them to you. So we have the historic lectionary, and basically the resources we have today give you Sundays and a few other feast days. But you might be surprised to find that the historic lectionary that the church used for 1,000 years or more included not just Sundays, but every Wednesday, every Friday, every day of Lent, just to name a few occasions. Lent is coming up, and how many of you pastors are thinking, what am I going to do for Lent? Right? Well, what if you had to ask that every Sunday? What am I going to do every Sunday? Of course not. Thanks be to God, you don't have to decide what you're going to preach every Sunday. You open the Bible, you know, you open the book, the lectionary, and see what the Word of God has for us this Sunday, right? So pastors used to not have to ask, what am I going to do for Lent? They simply opened the lectionary. So why don't we have this available to us today? So this is the project. Would you raise your hand if you are actively working in any capacity on this project right now? Take a look around the room. So there are quite a few people already contributing to the Lutheran Missal Project. Room for more people who want to help. If you want to know more, just Google Lutheran Missal Project or Lutheran Missal Blog. It will keep you up to date on what we're doing. It's some fantastic work going back, looking at the historic sources to bring this forward into English for the first time.
Thank you, Evan.
Oh, and when we're done, it will not be self-printed on Lulu. It will be a book published that looks like this, that is worthy of sitting next to the body and blood of Christ on the altar. So.